In this particular algorithm, we are going to discuss how to find whether an input number is positive, negative, or zero. We cannot use the simple if because the number has three possibilities. Neither can we use the if and else because if and else will give you like a flag. If one is condition is true, then you do something else, you do something else. Here, a number has three possibilities: positive, negative, or zero. So the first step what I will do is I will declare a memory location and I will call it number with the initial value zero. Even if I don't give any value initially, it doesn't really matter. Then I am going to ask the user to enter a number. So I am going to read a number from the keyboard. Once I read a number, I am going to do the following. I am first going to check if the number is greater than 0. So what I will say is if number is greater than 0, then print number is positive. So now I have eliminated the possibility that the number is positive. So if the number is not positive, what are the other two possibilities? It can either be negative or it can be 0. So after the if, I write else if number less than 0, then print number is negative. So I have taken care of positive number, I have taken care of negative number, and last when I come to the else, automatically the number has to be 0. So let's take a look at the code for it to make more sense to you. So first thing is I am reading a number. Once I read a number, first I'm going to use the if to check if the number is 0. I'm doing it a little differently, doesn't really matter. If the number is 0, then I'm going to print the message number is 0. Now if the number is not 0, it has to be either positive or negative only. There is no other possibility. So in the next else if, what I do is I check else space if number is less than 0. If the number is less than 0, then I am going to print the message number is negative. Now if the number is neither 0 nor negative, the number must be positive and I am not required to check this condition. So then I am going to say else print number is positive and I am going to stop. As usual, in order to understand the working of logic, it is really important that we go ahead and try to give it certain test cases. Let's take a number minus 6. Okay, so I am reading a number. Number is minus 6. Minus 6 is equal to 0. It's true or false? It is false. So this fellow does not get executed. It comes here. Else if number is minus 6. Is minus 6 less than 0? Now this part is true or yes. So it is going to say print number is negative and then going to come to stop. You need to understand one important concept here. If one of these condition is true, it will execute the block associated with that condition. It will not execute all three at all. It's not possible that it will execute this, this, and this at the same time. At the most, only one of these three is going to be executed. Let's take the number. This time, let's say 52. This is the second test. Read the number. Number is 52. If 52 is equal to 0, this is false. I come here. Else if 52 less than 0, this is also false. Then automatically I come to the else part because I know the number is not 0, not negative. So it has to be positive. So print number is positive. Now the simplest case, taking number as 0. Number is equal to 0. 0 is equal to 0. This is yes or true. Then I'm going to say print number is 0 and after this bracket I'm straight away going to come to stop. So moral of the story, it will execute only one of these blocks and not all three at the same given time. Now just to help you understand the general syntax, this is how the general syntax of the if, else if, else will take place. So after if, you can have as many else if as you want. You can have one else if, two else ifs, three else ifs, any number of else if. So I'm just showing you one, this thing. This, the last one after the if else if must be the else, okay? Or if the else is not required, you can omit it. If you only want to use the if else if, okay? Here also I could have said else if number greater than 0, then print number is 0. So in that case, I would never have had the else. But it makes sense to use the else, because if a number is not 0, not negative, it has to be positive. So I don't need to do that extra check. But you can always use, instead of a else, you can use a else if here. So if and then is same. Condition A is true. Number equal to 0 is the condition. I am asking a question. Is number equal to 0? This is the first condition. Second condition, number less than 0. So this is the second condition. Then the third one, I am not asking condition, because if this and this are false, this must be true. Alright. So this should give you an idea of one more decision control flow statement or a general construct, which changes the flow of execution of the instruction based on whether the condition is true or false. So if the condition is true, it will do this and not at all do this. That's why it is called as a decision control flow statement. So with this, we have finished the major types of decision making. If, I've shown you if else, and I've also shown you if else if, else if, else if, as many else if, and finally followed by a else, which is optional. So I hope you understand how you have to think using decision statements logically. I shall be giving you some simple problems to do on your own, so that you get an idea whether the logic is right or not on your own by using the test table or the test plan or the dry run.